This is Karangahape Road, central Auckland. Most people call it K Road. It's edgy, diverse and colourful. My name is Six. For many years, K Road was my home. I was homeless. Now I write and publish the K Road Chronicle, a newspaper that gives street people their own voice. This is my round. I know it and I love it. But now I want to venture out and hear stories from the homeless community who live beyond K Road.
So that's one of the pictures of me. Practically lived most of my time outside EB Games because there I couldn't even move. I couldn't even stand up.
Did you get a lot of judgment, prejudice, bigotry when you're on the street?
Oh, it was hard, eh? Mm. I'll say hard. I met a few other guys that were doing the solvents, like the glue. So I started up sniffing glue for a while. You know, you get all these random people driving past, get off that stuff, you bloody idiot. And, you know, they hear all sorts of mean stuff. But I'm just like, you know, just like, oh yeah, okay, have a good day, you know. Oh, was that bad, mate, that I was bleeding, literally bleeding on that. Like I had blood coming out of my legs, I had...
Out of your pores.
Yeah, out of everywhere. One time I went to hospital for the solvents. It came to the time where I almost died. And I didn't want people to knock at my door yet.
This was Wiremu's reality just 6 years ago. He was 260 kilos, homeless, and quite literally dying. There were many people who tried to help Wiremu. One of them was Linda, who works for the Auckland City Mission.
We were terribly worried about Wiremu. We brought him up to the old mission, showered him, and then took him straight into ED, where he was fast-tracked straight up to a ward. There were some fairly scary moments in the hospital.
Wiremu's size and life on the street was too much for his body to bear. Linda and the team at the mission found him somewhere to live.
Have you ever had any more problems with your legs like you had when you were on the street?
Nope.
Yeah, isn't that amazing?
He's been here for 5 years. Karatu House is an aged care facility, but it provided the perfect place for Wiremu's slow journey back to health.
Okay, how's the training going?
It's going good. Yeah. I'm hoping to get to it at least to 130.
Okay.
Yeah, but it doesn't mean like once I get to that goal weight, I'm not going to stop going to BBM.
That's right, because 150 was your goal weight when we first talked
about it. Yeah, and I'm nearly there.
Yes.
So I'll just keep on going until I get to where you are.
Meet my size.
I'll try.
That would be fantastic.
Oh, it would be.
Wiremu goes to 6 different exercise classes a week at Butterbean Motivation. BBM was started by Dave Latelli. Dave has turned his own life battles into a vital tool to help people like Wiremu. Let's talk about Wiremu, because when we ask Wiremu about you, he lights up. How did you guys meet?
I met him through one of our members works at Karetu House, and she asked me if I could come speak to these two guys. And I sort of said, well, where do you work? She goes, a rest home. I said, how old are these guys? And she goes, no, they're young fellows, they just need full-time care. So I went there. Wiremu could barely walk. And Dom, you know, rest in peace Dom, who didn't make it through the journey, he had to be wheeled into me. So I get there and I just speak to them, and I was only there to give a talk. And as soon as I saw them, I thought, geez, these guys need more than a motivational talk. They need my help. And now, you know, this guy, our first walk when we went outside was maybe after a month of working out inside the house. And we walked about 40 metres. I had to have a seat with me just in case he needed to sit down. And just after that, maybe a year later, he walked around the base, which is what, nearly 9Ks. He's done around the base twice now.
So this is me just after I had did the 9K walk. First time I started, I was a bit nervous because I didn't think I would make it. And then come to this year, I did it again. Been training for like about 2 years now.
With Butterbean?
Yeah, the old brown Butterbean. He was the one that changed my life around.
What we do here is what's missing in society. You know, the old saying, it takes a village to raise a baby, that's gone. Everyone's too busy trying to pay the bills and survive. You know, what we do here is really is like a marae. or a village in the islands, you know, where someone needs something, we're here for them. We surround them with positivity. We lift them up when they're down.
How important is that to people like Wiremu?
Camaraderie, you know, and that you know that people are there for you. Just with us here, if someone needs food, we're there. You know, if someone needs a hand moving, we're there. It's something that we're very big on. If you'll see in our sessions, you must encourage your partner. So our sessions are all partner sets. You have to encourage your partner. If you don't, we just restart the session.
Like all these people here, man, they, you know, they inspire me a lot. Especially this guy here.
Yeah.
His name is Phil.
Yeah.
His weight was 299 kgs.
Yeah.
Now he's lost 140.
Wow.
Through the through BBM. He was like my, you call it mentor or something. So he's the one that's actually got me on my feet by watching his journey.
Wiremu has always battled to keep his weight under control. At school, he was bullied for being large. His parents were heavy drug users, which added to his childhood trauma. As an adult, he struggled to deal with the legacy of his upbringing.
Well, I did have a job in living in a place in Mount Wellington. One night I just went into town and just splashed all my money. I won like two jackpots or one night. So I spent it all in town, just buying just a lot of weed and a lot of the white stuff, and just splashed it all in one night. And then didn't end up having any money to take home to pay for my living. So I began my journey living on the streets, and it was hard, eh?
Gambling and drug issues are common pathways to the streets. But as we talked, Wiremu revealed much more to his story.
Me and my dad, we weren't, like, close back then. We always used to argue. He always used to beat me up. And, like, my mum and dad broke up, ended up with someone else. He actually was all right because he actually got a job. He started looking after himself. And one night I went over there because my dad rang me and he goes, "Boy, what are you doing?" He said, "Oh, come over for dinner. We need to have a chat." And that's not like my dad. I went over to his place and his partner had dinner set on the table. And she said to me, I said, "Where's my father?" And she's like, "Oh, he's on his way home." I rang him, told him no dinner was ready. I was like, "Oh, okay. So anyway, we waited and waited. And then we had a knock at the door. And it was the police. And she answered it. Then all I heard was this big, loud scream and crying. He was deceased. Sorry. So it was hard. It was very hard. Because I remember before he said to me, you know, he loved me. And, you know, it just really hit me.
Wiremu's father had been tragically killed in a hit-and-run accident while on his way to reconnect with his son.
After he passed and we had his renewal, that's, honest to God, that's where it started, my journey.
Wiremu has managed to turn his life around, but many don't.
If far too many people die on the street, our homeless population tend to be 30 years older medically than they physically are. So 45-year-olds are actually showing the illnesses of a 70-year-old, but you can't get them into a rest home like Karatau.
How common is Wiremu's story?
Well, the fact that he's doing really well makes it unique.
This is where I live now.
There's nobody walking past throwing coins.
Don't think so.
So what do you do to relax?
Actually sit on my king-size bed and draw a lot of artwork.
Can we see some of that?
Yeah, sure.
The ducks.
Yeah, I'm a bit of a duck fan. The best drawing I like is probably that one.
Yeah, that's Starly.
Yeah. I went to Australia. I went to one of the big events over in Melbourne, 2018. It was a big thing because I've never been on a plane, man. You know, from living in a cardboard box to be flying overseas.
What does success look like?
A few more Wiremus. A few more stories like Wiremu. Maybe I can retire then.
Bit of kidnapping involved, but yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I don't actually mind getting kidnapped by my lady, but...
There were two ladies on that occasion.
Yeah, two ladies.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. That's good. Okay. Thank you very much.
Yeah, good.
That's cool.